experience.
Yes, please, Senior Bishop Joa.
Yes.
Yes, I'm a consultant surgeon urologist at Moi Teaching and Referral Hospital.
Consultant surgeon and urologist at Moi Teaching and Referral Hospital, Eldoret.
Yes, please.
Yes.
Yes, and therefore what I'm going to talk about tonight.
Yes, please.
My conscience is very clear.
You say your conscience is very clear.
Yes, because this is what I deal with every day.
This is what you're dealing with every day.
Yes, exactly, Senior Bishop Joan.
I know that we were waiting for you yesterday, but we heard that you were in the theater with a very serious case that needed your attention, and so we understood the urgency with which you were called to that surgery case that was there in the region, in Kericho. I know you are consulting for quite a few hospitals, but tonight we are blessed so much that you could find time to speak to us on the process of the reversal of death, Daktari.
Yes, Senior Bishop Joanna was very busy last night up to the middle of the night.
Yes.
You went as far as Kericho Retail Mission Hospital.
Yes, please.
And therefore, this is what I deal with every day.
This is what you deal with every day.
Yes.
Yes.
And therefore, the case of Mama Rosa.
Yes.
Yes, has taken my attention.
It took your attention, seriously.
Yes, because I've never come across it in any medical literature.
You say you've never come across this in any medical literature.
Yes, and I took very serious interest about this case and always documented from day one of how she has been doing.
You documented from day one how she has been doing.
Yes, please, Senior Bishop Joan.
Maybe we can give you time to read through the documentation from day one when she was resurrected up to what you have documented this far. You can interrupt and also explain. I will be maybe interrupting and asking for explanations on these processes of the reversal of death. But take it away, please, Daktari.
Amen, precious listeners of the Lord. For sure, this sign and wonder of this age.
Yes, please.
Yes, only we have been reading it in the book.
You've been reading it in the books.
Yes, and we thought most probably it was history.
In the Bible, yes, please.
But it attracted our attention and opened our minds to that truly the Bible is a living book.
You're saying it has really caught your attention and attracted your attention as doctors, and you've realized that the Bible is the living book.
Yes, it's exactly the way it's written that Jehovah has never changed. Jesus is the same today, yesterday, and forevermore.
Yes, please.
Yes, and please, Mama Rosa, for our listeners, most probably who are hearing this for the first time.
Yes, please.
Comes from South Pokot.
Mama Rosa comes from South Pokot.
In Chepartem.
Yes, please.
Yes, and therefore the husband was there when Mama Rosa died.
The husband was present when Mama Rosa died.
The children were there.
The children were present.
And therefore, what I have documented for the first few days.
Yes.
I've gotten it from them that were there, including the relatives.
Including the relatives.
Yes. So what I have documented the first day and when she died.
Yes.
It's a true reflection of exactly what happened because the husband was there.
It's a true reflection of what happened from gathering from the family and also the neighbors and the relatives.
Yes, because when Mama Rosa died, the relatives wailed and they ran outside, which attracted the attention of the relatives.
Yes, please.
Yes, and even the area chief heard about the death of Mama Sarah.
Yes.
Yes, because such a thing has usually attracts the attention of the administrator.
So the area chief also heard about the death of Mama Rosa.
Yeah, so it's something that is known in that area.
Yes, please.
And it has spread in that area like bushfire.
It has spread in that area all over the nation of Kenya and beyond to the world.
Yes, and therefore those who have been able to walk on foot have been camping in that house. And the compound of Mama Rosa since then.
You say people have been able to walk there. They have been camping ever since Mama Rosa died and was resurrected until now.
Yes, have been camping there because this is something that has never been heard, never been witnessed before.
That is very shocking.
Yes, just to tell our listeners how serious it is and how truly the whole county and the whole of Kenya and the entire world has been changed by this news of Mama Rosa who died under attack.
Yes, please, Doctor.
Yes, and just briefly, Mama Rosa was well in the day.
Yes, please.
Till in the afternoon.
Mama Rosa was well during the day until late in the afternoon?
Yes, and therefore there was a pit latrine nearby. We had to walk all the way up to the pit latrine.
She walked all the way to the pit latrine that evening?
And stayed longer than expected.
Yes, please.
Which attracted the attention of the daughter, Irene.
Yes.
And when Irene went there, she found that the mother wanted to come out and fell near a fence which was and leaned on a fence.
So she collapsed outside the pit latrine.
Yes, and Irene, the daughter, called the father, Pastor Samson.
Yes.
So Pastor Samson rushed there and carried Mama Rosa up to the house.
Yes, please.
And they took her to a house where Mama Rosa was placed on a bed.
She was carried into the house because she was not able to walk?
Yes, please.
Yes.
She had difficulty in breathing.
At that time, she had difficulty in breathing.
Yes.
Yes.
And she requested for a drink.
She requested to be given a drink.
And she was given milk, which she drank.
She was given milk and she drank the milk.
Yes, and the house became very cold and they brought in a chico.
They brought in a chico to warm, for
yes,
them to be warm.
Yes, but it was still very cold.
Yes.
That's when Mama Rosa realized most probably that she was dying.
Yes.
And she called in the children.
Yes.
To tell them, I'm now going.
Yes.
Stay with your father.
So she called in the children. She felt like she was losing breath. And she called in the children to tell them, I'm dying, but I feel like I'm going, but stay with your father.
Yes, especially she was interested with the youngest daughter who is 11 years old.
Yes.
Yes, and she told her that now you are grown up, please stay with your father.
Yes.
And she also advised or gave Samson the last words that, please, you have been taking care of me for all these years.
Yes.
You have been living together very well.
We have been living together very well all these years.
Yes, take care of our children.
And then he told him to take care of their children.
Yes, just to let our listeners know that truly it was a serious thing and Rosa knew. And that some people usually know when they're about to die. Those are the signs of death.
Yes.
Yes, and when she said that.
Yes.
She was left to lie on the bed.
She was left there lying on the bed.
Yes, because she would not sit anymore. She was too sick to sit.
She could not sit at all on the bed at that time.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, after mentioning that, I'm telling the children to stay in peace. I'm now going. In other words, now I'm leaving my body.
Yes.
That's, in other words, I'm dying.
Yes, please.
Yes, she belched.
Oh.
A very big sound.
Oh, she belched. A very big sound came out of belching.
Yes, and urinated on herself.
And then passed out urine. But what does it mean that she belched? Medically.
Yes, yes, listen up, just to tell you exactly what it means. It means that those are the stages of death.
That is another sign of, a stage of death.
Yes, before locomotive sets in.
Yes.
The stiffness of all the muscles of the body.
Before rigor mortis takes place, that the stiffness of the muscles of the body.
Yes, this is usually what we call primary flaccidity, where the all muscles of the body relax.
Yes, primary flaccidity.
Yes, and when all the muscles of the body relax, the epiglottis is opened up.
Yes.
And that's why air gushed out and she belched. Something like this. It's a note that, as our doctor usually hear, it's quite common when I'm there and there's a sitting patient.
Yes.
When I'm called by the nurse that a patient is very sick, please come and do something.
Yes.
Usually when they die, usually give that such a type of sound.
Yes, so whenever you are resuscitating, you've seen this quite a number of times.
Yeah, we call it the last breath.
The last breath.
The last breath.
In this severally and many times, the last breath.
Yeah, the last breath.
Once they belt, you know, it is done. It's...
Yes, please.
Yes.
And it seems the blood full at that time.
Yes.
because most, she had gone to the toilet, and most probably she did reach the toilet or something like that.
Yes, please.
And therefore, when the primary flaccidity set in, all the muscles relaxed.
Yes.
Including the sphincters.
Yes.
That's why urine came out.
Yes.
And she related on the bed. That tells you how serious it was.
That is how serious
it was.
Again, you're saying many times when the nurses call you when a patient is too sick and about to go, about to die, about to pass out, about to pass away, and you see these signs, they belch out, and then sometimes they release the bladder, they urinate on themselves, then you realize as a doctor that you've lost that patient.
Yes, please. And if she was in a hospital setting,
yes, please,
would have started what you call CPR.
Yes.
Cardiopulmonary resuscitation.
Yes.
And you would have intubated her.
Yes.
Given her drugs to restart or to keep the heart beating.
Yes.
But since she was not in that setting.
Yes.
Yes, and that is so remote that even you don't think of a hospital.
Yes, please.
And there are no medical personnel around.
There was no medical personnel around.
They are not near.
They are not near.
No, yes, and the network there, the mobile network is so poor.
Yes, please.
That's why there is nothing. What I thought of.
Yes.
Was only prayer.
It was only prayer.
Yes, and so when Mama Rosa gave that last breath, sounds.
Yes, the belching.
Signifying the last breath.
Yes, please.
Yet the doctor even tells me.
Yes.
She looked at her mother, was not breathing anymore.
She looked at her mother and realized she was not breathing anymore.
And that's what we use also in the hospital. Usually check whether, because breathing is something which is so obvious.
Yes.
That you see the chest rising and going down.
Yes.
It's something that is obvious to anybody, even in the hospital setting.
Yes.
That's what the nurse usually tells us, that doctor, rush here, the patient is not breathing anymore.
Yes.
Yes, because breathing signifies life.
Yes, please.
Yes, and the other thing that signifies that the patient is still alive and can be saved is the heart.
The heart, yes.
And therefore, Ivan, the daughter who is 20 years old,
yes,
felt the left side of the chest, and that's where the heartbeat usually is felt.
Yes.
And there was no heartbeat.
There was no heartbeat.
Yes, Ivan again felt the legs and the body and was turned cold.
They turned cold.
Yes, please.
Yes, please.
The father also did the same, but at this time, Ivan tells us, the father started getting confused.
Oh, when the father checked and found these signs also, he became confused.
Yes, because he's a mature man and he knew surely death has come to his house.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, please.
The other thing that I feel did.
Yes, please.
Was that the eyes were wide open.
The eyes became wide open.
So Ivan started to close the eyelids, but they could not be closed.
Ivan, the daughter, tried to pull the eyelids down to close the eyes, but the eyes could not close.
Yes, she tried to flex the hands, the legs, they would not be flexed.
Ah, she even tried to flex the hands and they could not flex.
Yes, because the hands were outstretched.
The hands were stretched.
And the tongue was out.
And the tongue was also out.
Yes.
Yes, please.
So rigor mortis was setting in.
Rigor mortis was setting in.
Yes, and when I even noticed that, she knew that the mother was dead.
Yes.
She went to the other house, to the upper room, brought a bed sheet or a lasso.
Yes.
And covered the dead body.
She brought a bed sheet and covered the dead body.
Yeah, that's what we call the death certificate. In fact, even in hospitals, when we realize that a patient has died,
yes,
we cover them completely.
You cover them completely.
Yes, and put a curtain all around so that the other patients do not see the patient.
Yes, the dead body.
As we make an arrangement to take that patient, that body to the mortuary.
Yes, please. Normally, they are once totally covered.
Once you have confirmed that truly the patient has died.
Yes, please.
And one of the confirmation is that there is no heart attack.
Yes.
The pupils are fully dilated.
The pupils are fully dilated.
Not reacting to light.
Not reacting at all to light.
They will see that there is absence of brainstem. There are no reflexes.
Everything is done.
In other words, brain death has set in.
And the brain death has set in.
Yes, precious listeners.
Yes.
If the brain do not get oxygen for around 5 minutes.
If the brain does not get oxygen for around 5 minutes.
Brain death sets in. That's the death of the patient. Once the brain is dead, then the whole body is dead.
Brain death occurs. So explain to us a bit about brain death.
Yeah, because apnea sets in, you don't breathe because the brain stem is dead. And that controls the breathing system.
The brain stem dies, which controls the breathing.
Yes, and there are no reflexes. The reflexes that arise from the brain stem.
Yes, please.
So to me, I want to listen to the daughter and the father.
Yes, please.
All those were there, but this patient was dead.
This patient was dead.
Yes.
Yes.
And that's now when Mama, Dr. Samson, the husband of Mama Rosa.
Yes, please.
The only thing that he remembers was to call the nearest senior pastor.
The only thing he remembered was to call his senior pastor.
And the first time he called them when Mama Rosa was very sick and difficult in breathing.
Yes, please.
Told them, please, let's pray for my wife. She's very sick.
So when he first called, that was the case. She was losing breath. She was having difficulty in breathing, but had not died, and was telling them, please pray for my wife.
Yes, and also the ladies from Acacia in another house. The widows were in Acacia. That was on a Wednesday, the 21st of June.
Yes, please.
So he remembered them.
Yes.
I thank God that that's the only thing that he would have done, because if he had called any doctor, no doctor would have done anything.
Yes, please.
Yes, because I don't think even if I was called as a doctor, I don't know what I would have done in such a short time.
Yes.
Yes.
There was nothing that could be done.
Yes, and so after 2 minutes, he called them back.
Yes.
And told them that Mama is gone.
Samson called them back to tell them, to break the bad news to them that, she is gone, she is dead.
She is dead, exactly.
Yes, please.
Yeah, maybe culturally.
Yes.
Because also culture comes in such issues.
Yes, please.
Yeah, those are the people who rarely mention about death. They don't mention death when you are not dead.
They use words, other words, to make it a little bit more polite.
Yeah, make it more polite, and again.
Yes.
They don't say that you are dead when you are not dead.
Yes.
It's not acceptable culturally.
Okay. Culturally, it's not acceptable to say that someone has died when they have not died.
Yes, or somebody has gone when he has not gone. In other words, has
died.
When he's not dead. You don't even come closer to that.
Yes, you never come close to that, according to that culture. Yes.
Yeah, when that you are dead, you are surely dead.
When they say you are dead, you are surely dead.
Because when they mention that you are dead and you are not dead, it means a lot of, I mean, culturally it involves a lot of, if you are not saved, cleansing, cultural cleansing.
Oh, it require a lot of, according to them and their culture, a lot of cleansing and all that. So they don't use that on anyone who is living.
Exactly, exactly. So you have to be sure of what you are saying about.
Yes. So they checked and ensured and also confirmed and affirmed that she was gone.
Yes, for sure.
Yes, please.
So when she called them, I told them, now Mama Rosa is gone. You know what? She has died.
Yes, please.
Yes. That's when Pastor Peres, the senior pastor,
yes, please,
wrote a message to the mightiest Spirit of the Lord.
That is when the senior pastor, Pastor Jairus, sent a text message to the mightiest prophet of the Lord.
Yes.
Yes.
And the message came.
Yes, please.
Saying it is well.
Then the text message came back in response saying it is well.
Yes, and Pastor Jairus called Pastor Samson and called the widows.
Yes, please.
And a celebration started.
A celebration started in front of a dead body.
Yes, was speaking.
Yes.
They knew that he who was speaking.
Yes.
Speaks directly to them.
They knew that he who has spoken it is well has a clear relationship with God the Father.
Yes, and therefore what he was writing about was truly from the Lord.
What he was saying was truly from the Lord, yes.
Yes, and therefore they started rejoicing.
They started rejoicing.
They celebrated.
Celebrated.
In fact, Pastor Jairus were planning now, because when they heard that Mama Rosa is dead, they were planning now to go that night.
Yes, please.
to go and comfort him and help him during that hard time.
They were planning, even after sending the message, they were still planning to go and comfort him because he has lost his wife.
Yes, before the message. But when the message arrived,
yes,
Pastor Jairus and the wife started celebrating that midnight. It was around midnight.
Yes, please.
The widow started celebrating.
The widow started celebrating.
And Pastor Samson, husband of Mama Rosa.
And the husband of Mama Rosa also.
Called his children who had already run outside wailing.
The children, he called the children that were outside wailing.
But please come in, there are good news here.
Hallelujah, that's so powerful, calling them in to hear the good news that had come.
And just to show them that truly what he was saying was true, he showed them his mobile phone, the message that is written, it is well.
He showed them the text message on his mobile phone saying it is well.
Yes, then a celebration started.
Yes.
Besides a dead body.
Besides a dead body, that is shocking.
Very powerful.
Yes, please.
They celebrated for nearly 1.5 hours.
They celebrated for nearly 1.5 hours after their message came.
Yes, because that message is so powerful.
Yes, please.
And they knew where the message was coming from.
Yes, please.
Yes, they knew who wrote the message.
Yes, please.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And therefore, after 1.5 hours...
Yes, please.
Suddenly, Mama Rosa started sneezing and coughing.
Mama Rosa started sneezing and coughing.
Oh, yes, please, Senior Bishop John and man, the listeners of the Lord.
Yes, please.
That sneezing is so powerful.
Yes, please.
That sneezing is...
Describe for us, Dr.
Yes, because the sneezing reflex...
Yes, please.
That result that could have caused that sneezing, and that sneezing is so important.
Yes.
Yes, as a doctor, I've never heard such a thing because people don't resurrect in the hospitals.
You say, as a doctor, you've never heard of such a thing because people don't resurrect in hospitals.
Yes.
Yes.
That was the reason why Mama Rosa...
Yes.
...is written in the Bible.
It is only that which is written in the Bible that you have heard about.
Yes, the only thing I've read that somebody sneezed when he resurrected.
Yes, please.
Yes, by elf.
Yes.
Yes, and the reason why Mama Rosa sneezed or people from the sneeze.
Yes.
Yeah, it's the reflex of sneezing is in the brainstem. It's in the brain.
It's in the brainstem.
And therefore, when now life came back to the brain.
When life came back to the brain.
Yes, that's now that center was stimulated.
Yes.
In matter of hours, it was announcing that now I'm alive, I'm back.
Oh, that was a big announcement that this I'm alive, I'm back. Hey.
Yes, because those are the last reflexes to die when brain death sets in.
Yes, please.
And that would be the first one also to come back and tell them that now my brain stem is active.
Yes.
And that was the sneezing also clears the secretions in the airway.
The sneezing clears the secretions in the airway.
Like because this was someone who had died, and therefore secretions had come into the body to the mouth, to the nose, to the airways.
Why do that happen, Doctor?
Christians come in.
Yes, please.
When you start breathing, they choke your breathing. They choke you. You don't breathe well.
Yes.
So we have to clear those to start out the normal breathing.
Yes.
Yes, and started also coughing to expand the lungs.
Oh, that coughing also happened to expand the lungs that had collapsed.
Yes, because the lungs had collapsed and there were secretions most probably in the lungs.
Yes.
Because all systems had stopped.
All systems had stopped.
Yes, for my precious listeners.
Yes, please.
Usually the brain takes 5 minutes to die if there is no oxygen.
It takes 5 minutes only and the brain dies if there is no oxygen.
Yeah, the kidneys slightly take longer time than the heart.
Yes.
Around 20 to 40 minutes.
Yes.
The kidneys stop functioning, they die, the heart muscles stop, they die completely.
Again, you're saying the kidney takes how long before it stops and dies completely?
Yeah, so the kidney takes 20 to 40 minutes after death, the heart, it's important for us doctors who are doing organ transplants.
Yes, please.
That you can remove a kidney of someone who died 20 minutes ago and still use it on another person.
Yes, please.
But if Rosa took more than 1.5 hours, most probably 2 hours.
when the message came, it took 1.5 hours for her to come back, but she had died for quite some time before the message came.
Yes, please.
Yes, please. So more than 2 hours. Yes, please.
By all standards.
Yes.
All the organs had died.
By all standards, all the organs had died.
Yes.
Yes.
And death is irreversible.
And death is irreversible.
Yes, irreversible, complete. There is no way you can reverse death.
There is no way you can reverse death.
Yes, so my listeners, what I'm speaking about is I cannot explain on medical terms how now the heart was able to come. They had started pumping blood.
Yes, please.
I don't know how the kidneys came back when they start functioning and produce urine.
So you're going to help us maybe the possibilities from medicine, from the death of these organs, and now that they are functioning. Shocking.
Yes. Yes, please.
Yes.
Usually people smell because the cells start dying and they rot.
Oh, yes, please. People smell.
Within a very short time.
Yes, please.
Your cells lyse themselves because there is no energy to regulate.
Yes.
The cell function.
There is no energy to regulate the cell functions.
And therefore, when you die and there is no energy, the cells burst now and the enzymes are released outside, which they start digesting the body.
The cells burst when someone dies and then start releasing from it. So that is the reason why the body is rot so quickly.
Exactly, yes.
Yes. You see, the cells die.
They release the enzymes.
Yes.
The enzymes start digesting them in the body.
Yes, please.
Bacteria then start working on the body, decomposing the body.
Oh, yes, please.
Yes, and it starts very fast. Smell starts very fast.
The smell begins very fast.
That's why usually people don't keep bodies for more than even hours in the house with dead bodies.
People don't keep dead bodies because they will just start smelling. The entire place will start smelling.
Because it starts smelling.
Yes, please.
Yes, my precious listeners.
This is very amazing. We're getting to understand deeper. Yes, please.
So when Mama Rosa resurrected.
Yes.
But the daughter says she wanted to run away.
She wanted to run away.
When the mother sneezed and coughed.
Yes, please.
That was for sure. According to her, dead people don't come back.
Yes, dead people do not come back.
I don't know what was in her mind. Not because she was speaking. Of course, something else.
Yes, please.
In fact, when Pastor Samson told the daughter to hold the mother, she refused.
She refused, she feared.
For the first few minutes.
Yes, please.
Till the father went and took hold of the mother.
Yes, please.
That's what the daughter now even came to pass and said, this is my mother.
Oh, yes, please.
Yes, please.
Traumatized and feared to touch a dead body.
Yeah, that tells you how serious it was and how real it was.
Yes, please.
Yes, please.
Very shocking.
So the following day, in the morning of Thursday, that's 22nd.
22nd.
Now that's when Pastor Jairus went in and the widows who were on Acacia went out to visit Mama Rosa.
To visit this home where a dead body has been resurrected.
That because when they celebrated the message of the might from the Lord, the mighty prophet of the Lord.
Yes, please.
They were sure that those words were real.
Yes, please.
And therefore they did not have any doubt.
Yes.
Yes, so when they came the following morning.
Yes.
One thing that I just took that history and asked them that visited the first day.
Yes.
They said Mama Rosa was smelling badly.
Oh, Mama Rosa was smelling badly.
In fact, they described it was like a smell of death.
There was still the smell of death in her body.
In her body.
That is very stunning.
Yes, that's on the first, that's the 22nd, the second day.
22nd.
Or the morning of her resurrection.
Yes, I can see that in your documentation of her, the process of the reversal of death, you've documented from 21st to 22nd, actually, yes.
Yes, so even the breath was very bad.
The breath was very, very smelly.
Yes, very smelly.
Yes.
And I was talking to Mama Rosa this afternoon.
Yes.
She told me she did not know what happened the first day.
The first day she did not know what happened.
But she said she was not able to see anything.
Oh, she was not able to see anything on the
or
first
hear anything.
She could not see or hear anything.
But I confirmed from Mama Ruth, that was among the widows visited at the first day.
Yes.
And was telling us, even on the third day, she didn't know who visited at the following day.
Ah, the third day she did not know who came to visit her on the first day, the second, first and second day?
Yes, please. She didn't have 5 stones.
Yes.
That's why she was starting afresh.
Yes.
She was high, but she could not perceive anything. She would not document anything what she had seen. People thought she was seen, but she was like a child.
She was like a child.
Yes, she could not hear anything.
Yes.
And her breathing was very... She still had difficulty in breathing.
She still had difficulty in breathing.
Well, she could not complete her sentence without having a pause, if you ask her something.
Yes.
Yes, that was on 22nd.
Yes, please.
23rd was still the same. The smell was there, but had gone down.
The smell of death was still there, but had gone down.
Yes, and the hands which were outstretched during the rigor mortis.
Yes, please.
When she resurrected, she flexed her hands.
Yes.
Which are still flexed up to now, but for sure there's a big improvement.
Yes, please.
Yes, she could not. The hands were still flexed at the elbow.
Yes, please.
She was lying on the bed continuously.
Yes, please.
And they tried to give her milk the first day, but she vomited.
Yes, please.
So she only took half a cup of milk.
The first day she tried to take milk, but she couldn't.
She couldn't?
Yes.
Well, when she died, all the organs shut down.
When she died, all the organs had shut down.
Including the alimentary canal.
Yes, please.
So she didn't have any appetite, and for sure when she tried to take nothing, she had difficulty in swallowing.
She had difficulty in swallowing.
Yes, that's the first day of her resurrection and the second day.
That is shocking. Why? What died on the throat and that system for her to have been having difficulty in swallowing also?
Yes, please.
Yes.
So the muscles had not started to function properly.
Muscles had not started functioning properly.
Yes, the oropharyngeal muscles that assist that helps in swallowing.
Yes, please.
And the tongue also.
And the tongue also. The tongue was dead also.
Was dead, yes.
Yes, please.
So on Saturday 24th of June.
Yes, please.
That's the first time she tried to drink, but not yet.
Yes.
We were forcing her to eat.
Yes, please.
So that she could eat.
Yes.
But herself, she didn't have the appetite.
She didn't have the appetite at all.
Yes, she was still a corpse.
Yes.
Yes, yes.
So, what died? What happened that you could not have the appetite back?
Initially, you need to get energy for your body to function.
Yes, please.
So, since the body had died, the cell did not need energy anymore.
Yes.
So, the energy that was needed by cells was so minimal because the function of the cells was very minimal too.
The functioning of the cells were very minimal, and so she needed very little also. So what was being triggered in the brain or where? Explain to us, help us to understand this. Was it that what the brain was sending, that there is need for food or energy, was so little also?
Yes.
Yes.
In fact, it's a miracle, Senior Bishop John, because at 13,
yes,
he would have given her fluids through the veins.
Yes.
Yeah, but in this case, there were no fluids, there was no hospital nearby.
Yes.
Also given a glucose.
Yes.
Through the veins.
Yes.
And then even living on the first day is still a miracle, even to me.
You say even for her to have lived through that one day after being resurrected from the dead is a miracle. To you, you were shocked as a doctor.
Yes, because I'm sure the blood pressure was very low. Nobody checked the blood pressure.
Yes.
Yes, and I'm sure all things were abnormal.
Everything in our body on that first day, the first few days of our resurrection, were very abnormal.
I'm sure the electrolytes were abnormal, so the potassium and all the electrolytes were abnormal.
Yes, please.
And I'm sure also the acidity in the body.
Yes, please.
The pH was very low.
The pH was very low.
Yes, so all things were abnormal.
Everything, all things were abnormal.
In fact, she should have been ill.
So you should have been in the ICU.
Yeah, when she resurrected, if there was a hospital nearby, if I was near the doctor.
Yes, please.
I would have practiced to a bigger hospital.
To a bigger hospital in an ICU.
Yes, but those words, it is well, were still working.
The intensive care of the Lord, it is well, was still working.
Yes, because once the Lord does something, he does it.
Yes.
You don't assist the Lord.
I am surprised because you're saying it is such a big miracle that she even lived through the first day of her resurrection.
Yes, because when I saw her on the second day.
When you saw her now on the second day.
When I wanted to rush her to the hospital, I was so scared.
You, as a doctor, you were so scared, you wanted to just take this patient quickly to the hospital.
I thought she would die on my hands.
You said you thought she would die on your hands.
Yeah, to be sincere, I was so worried that now how can somebody resurrect and die again on my hands?
Yes, please.
But when I remember the words of the Lord, it is well.
Yes, please.
I said, who am I?
Yes.
I was not there when she resurrected. How can I pretend that I would do something?
Yes.
When the Lord himself brought him from the dead.
But that's a genuine concern from a doctor's point of view.
Yes, that is how serious it was, Senior Bishop Joanne.
Yes, please.
But as a doctor, I would not be comfortable to sit with her, not take her to a nearby hospital.
Yes, as a doctor, you would not have been comfortable sitting there with her and seeing her state and knowing that all activities, all the organs in the body and her functions are totally abnormal. You are shocked that she lived.
Very shocked, Bishop Young. When I saw her.
Yes.
Naturally, patients.
Yes.
She didn't do anything with them.
Yes.
That they might die again.
Yes.
She looked very pale, pepper white, very dehydrated.
Yes.
And this somebody who is not fed, while she was only taking half a cup of water or milk.
Yes, please.
But so sure, it's a miracle that she was able to survive those first few days.
That is very stunning.
In that cold area of the apartment.
Yes, please.
Yes, please.
Very shocking, very stunning.
But still on the fourth day, that on 25th of June.
25th of June, that was on Sunday.
They started supporting her to sit.
Yes, please.
Because initially she could not sit for more than even 1 minute.
Yes.
She became very tired, very restless.
Yes.
And her kidney beating very fast.
Yes.
So we started holding her to sit on bed and take some milk and porridge.
Yes, please.
On 26th, that's on a Monday.
Yes, please.
Things started changing.
Yes.
Appetite came in.
The appetite came in.
She regained her appetite. Very beautiful.
But before, on this all these days, from day 1 up to 25th of June,
yes,
there was almost zero appetite. And then all of a sudden it set in full force. Did it shock you as a doctor?
Yeah, we are forcing her to eat because we are really encouraging her, forcing her to take something.
Yes.
Because that's the only thing we would have done to her.
Yes.
Or else she needed IV fluid, she needed dextrose through the IV line.
Yes.
Yes, but all this time we were forcing her to eat and even to sit was a problem.
Yes.
Yeah, and we thought all this time she was seeing, but now she seems like she was not able to see anybody all that time.
Ah, all that time she was not able to see anybody.
Yes, and she could not remember who visited her that day.
She could not remember who had visited her.
But because the brain function was coming back, when she has all her memory.
Yes.
Yes, when she died.
Yes.
All that was in her brain was erased.
Ah, when she died, she also lost her memory when she came back.
Yes.
Yes,
please.
That is shocking because I remember a part of her testimony, she also said that when she came back, she was shocked that she's able to speak in Swahili.
Yes, I came back.
Yes.
I forgot my precious listeners.
Yes.
But when she came back, she asked, who brought me back?
Yes, please.
And that's when her Swahili started. Yes.
So there is a miracle within this great sign and wonder, also another miracle inside the miracle.
Yes, a miracle inside a miracle.
Yes, please.
That she did not Swahili.
She was not able to communicate in Swahili.
So this is the first time she started saying, Nani amenirudisha, who has brought me back.
Yes, please.
Yes.
Shocking, very stunning, very shocking miracle here.
Yes, in fact, when you ask her now, she does not remember saying those words, but the people who are there.
Yes, please.
Still remember her saying like that.
Yes.
Yes, and that's how our Kiswahili started.
Amazing, very amazing. So for 5 days, if I counted well, I don't know whether it's 5 or 6 days, she was not able to see also.
Yes, and she could not memorize anything.
Memory was erased and she was blind. She couldn't see. She was seeing but not seeing, could not perceive anything.
Yes, please.
Yes.
Then on the 26th of June.
Yes.
That's when her memory, but now to remember who assisted me, who came today and who came yesterday. That was on the 26th.
Yes.
Yes, and she started, she regained her appetite.
She regained her appetite on 26th.
In fact, she was eating after effort 2 hours or one, but food was taken, but we were so happy.
Yes.
That we put everything available in that village.
You made everything available for her as you watched this shocking reversal of the process of death.
Yes, yeah, she needed meat, she needed liver.
Yes.
She needed milk.
Milk, yes.
And she was taking little by little bit, but frequently.
Frequently.
Not even throughout the night.
Yes.
We were so happy that we were awake with her. Whenever she needed food, we had food for her.
Yes.
Yes, that was on the 6th of June. That's when he started feeding like any other person.
Yes, please.
The appetite came back.
Yes.
And the memory came back.
The appetite came back and the memory came back also.
Yes, and that is the time we noticed also that the feet were swollen.
That's when you noticed the feet were swollen.
Yes.
So, now, you talked about the brain dead and all the functions and reflexes gone. Now, this time around, on 26th, she was able to eat, she could tell she's hungry, and she could also remember people, and she was now able to eat. So what must have been triggered or touched by the Lord in the brain for her to be able to now function normally like that, and eat normally like anyone else, and even frequently, because now she could feel she's hungry and she could tell?
Yes, please, because this person was dead, all the organs had died.
Yes, please.
Even the pulmonary colon, I'm sure the stomach was collapsed, the intestines collapsed, there was not a peristalsis.
Yes.
And then when they started coming back.
Yes.
Then the brain also, all this time.
Yes.
Because I'm sure when you have ischemic brain injury.
Yes.
Like irreversible brain injury, they rarely reverse. You don't reverse brain injury.
It is irreversible. Brain injury is irreversible.
It's irreversible.
Yes.
And then for brain death, everything is death.
That's just an injury.
Yeah, that's extreme, but now the brain injury is dead.
Yes.
So all things are there.
Yes.
So I think all this time, the brain now.
Yes.
Was recovering from the severe injury from the hypoxia.
Yes.
Yes, and it took all this time around 5 days.
Yes.
I don't know whether you say 5 days because they do not recover in the first place.
They don't recover at all.
They don't recover at all.
Yes.
That was this a miracle.
Yes.
That the Lord was timing the appetite for
yes.
the brain to claim food.
Yes.
Was being timed by the intestines also. Was being timed also with the stomach to receive food.
Yes.
Yes, for the stomach to put the intestines to develop the peristalsis.
Yes.
To allow digestion to take place.
Yes.
So it took around 5 days. We are now writing a new book, which has never been written.
You are now writing a new book, Professor, which has never been written before.
Yes. And
yes.
What would have happened is that now the brain recovered fully on the 6th day.
Yes.
6th day.
Mm-hmm.
That's why she was able to regain her memory.
Yes.
And remember people.
Yes, please.
Yes, and the intestines also recovered their functions.
Yes, please.
Yes. Because the appetite was so high.
Yes.
And we were still holding her to sit down, but this time she could sit for longer.
Yes, please.
But thank the Lord that she could sit for longer to eat all this food that the body needed.
Yes, please.
Yes. So the Lord is a God of order.
Very amazing. This is shocking. Very shocking.
Yes.
Yes.
On 27th of June.
Yes.
The appetite still was very high.
Yes.
One thing that we noticed was now this time she could sit without support.
She could sit without support.
Very powerful, because this time now she can sit without support and eat the way she wanted to eat now.
Yes.
Nobody holding her.
Nobody holding her.
Yes, that's on the seventh day.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, that is very powerful.
Then something that, as I told you, when I saw her the first time, she was very pale.
Yes.
But on Wednesday 28th, that's when we started seeing some blood vessels on her conjunctiva eyes.
Wednesday is when you started seeing, now for the first time, the blood vessels in the eyes.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, as a doctor, I was so happy to see that.
As a doctor, you were very happy to see that.
Yes, now I was comfortable now to be with her.
What does that mean, that the blood vessels could be seen and before it could not be seen?
Yes, and now the blood vessel, the blood level is coming up. The hemoglobin most probably now was coming up.
Yes.
Yes, we didn't check because there was no hospital around there, so we did not check the blood, the hemoglobin level.
Yes, please, but you could
that
tell.
That tells you now that the blood was increasing in her body.
But in your examination, you could tell that it was low.
Yes, and also the other thing was that the blood vessels which had collapsed on her skin were now coming up.
Yes.
But because when you die, usually within few minutes, like around 3 minutes.
Around 3 minutes.
The blood clots, usually in the 3 to 15 minutes, is the entire blood clots in the body.
Yes, 3 to 15.
So that's another miracle. I don't know how the blood which had clotted.
Yes.
Essentially, normally.
Yes.
Liquefied back again, started to flow in the veins.
Yes.
So this is a very powerful miracle, big miracle, signs and wonder of this age.
So there are many miracles inside the miracle and the sign and the wonder.
Yes.
Yes, please.
So on 28, that's when we saw the blood vessels on her eyes.
Yes, please.
Yes, and the appetite still continued to increase.
Yes, please.
Yes, please.
Very powerful.
Then, on 2nd of June, that was on July, that was on a Sunday.
Yes.
We took her to a loaded main altar.
Yes.
And she was being carried. She could not walk.
She could not walk. So all this time, she was not able to walk.
Yes. In fact, our joy was she was able to sit on herself, but she could not walk.
Yes.
So she was carried to a loaded main altar from the circle to where she sat in the altar.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, please.
Then another big thing, precious listeners, this whole time she was feeding.
Yes.
But she had not opened her bowels.
Oh, yes, please.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
So on 3rd of July, that was on a Monday.
Yes, please.
Around 2 weeks down the line.
Yes, yes, please. 2 weeks.
She went to the bathroom, the washroom.
Yes, please.
To relieve herself.
For the first time in 2 weeks.
That was my joy. As a doctor, I know that those are the signs that somebody is becoming well.
So, now, let me just get back to you now on this one. Oh, for 14 days, you were documenting the processes of the reversal of death in her body, the functions of her body. Some of them would shock you, would make you uncomfortable as a doctor. Did this one also, that for 14 days she was not able to relieve herself, did this one make you fear? Did it worry you as a doctor, and why?
It worried me a lot because...
Yes.
From experience, after first, somebody has not taken something for a long time.
Yes, please.
Usually, when you go to the washroom for the first time.
Yes, please.
The stool are very hard.
Yes.
But usually, the first stool is taken a lot.
Yes, and this is 14 days almost.
Yes, and remember that this lady went to the bathroom and collapsed there.
Yes.
So my wonder was, how was she going to push that stool out? The first stool is usually very hard.
Yes.
And the body has not functioned properly.
And the body has not functioned properly. She's just come back from death.
In fact, I was waiting between giving a laxative or something like that to have evacuated the stool.
Yes.
In a hospital setting, I would have given an enema.
Yes.
Enema is washing the rectum to stimulate the stool to come.
Yes.
That's the ideal thing we do.
Yes.
Or give a stool softener.
Yes.
Precious leaders, this is the daughter of the Lord whose load was under control.
So again, this one shocked you. The Lord did another miracle in your eyes.
Very big miracle. It was the reason why I rejoiced that day.
Yes.
Was because she went to the bathroom. She did not strain.
Yes.
Because it was not a big issue to her.
It was, for you, it was totally abnormal for because 14 days without going to the restroom, and she was not eating well, and then finally she was eating very well, very, very well, eating a lot of appetite, and then 14 days later she had not been able to go to the restroom, and now she goes to the restroom and it was just normal. She just went and came back.
I just went and came back. Usually patients make a lot of noise when they are there. They come back and they tell you, "Doctor, I have gone to the washroom."
Yes.
The tool is very hard. I cannot evacuate myself.
Yes.
Yes, and usually assist them.
Yes.
This is a lady that was never assisted in any way.
The Lord Himself did it.
Lord Himself, Senior Bishop Johan, did it.
This is very mighty.
When you see a doctor rejoicing, that's a big miracle to that doctor.
Yes, please.
Yes, that's why I was so happy.
Yes.
When I was told that she went to the bathroom and it was not a big thing to her.
Ay, that is very shocking. Yes, please.
Yes, please.
Very mighty. So that is after day 14.
Day 14, because there was nothing in the intestines.
Yes, please.
Yes, please. I the reason why she took that long was there was nothing in the intestines.
Yes, please.
The intestines had collapsed.
The intestines had collapsed.
Number two, whatever she ate, the body was maximizing to the maximum. There was nothing to be wasted.
Yes.
Yes. All that she did was being reabsorbed, was being absorbed to the body.
Yes, yes.
She needed all the protein, she needed all the glucose, she needed all the vitamins, she needed all that she took.
Yes, please.
Yes, please. That's why the body was really utilizing what she took.
Yes.
And therefore, what was getting down there was really the wasted stuff.
Yes.
Yes, and it was a miracle that the intestines, which had collapsed, was able to push that stool outside without her being assisted.
Yes.
Yes.
Very amazing, very shocking story here.
Yes, one thing that I wanted to mention also was that when she was lying on the bed,
yes,
somebody had to assist her to sit.
Somebody had to assist her to be able to sit.
Yes, she had to call somebody.
Yes.
And her voice was not reaching that far.
Hey.
So we were always, somebody was always with her.
Somebody had to always be with her.
That was the daughter, Irene, was always with her.
Yes, please.
And Naomi.
Yes.
A lady which also, so that it could be two.
Two people assisting her to be able to sit
so
up.
That when one is not there, the other one is with her.
Yes, please.
Because she always needed to be there. If she needed something, if she needed to help herself, if she needed to be held, if she needed to be given food, somebody was there.
Yes.
Oh, yes, something that I didn't mention, we were feeding her.
Oh, she was being fed. She was not able to feed herself.
Yeah, we were feeding her up to 20, I think on a Tuesday.
Yes, please.
Then she started feeding herself.
Yes.
And she was able now to take her hands all the way to the mouth.
Oh, so her hands were stuck for quite some time.
Yes, up to the sixth day.
After the sixth day, her hands, the picture we are seeing here, which has been copied and put in the banners, shows her hands stuck together and stiff.
Yes, please.
So that was up to day six when her hands were still stiff and stuck together, Dr. Ri.
Yes, and somebody was feeding her, like a child.
So she had to be fed like a baby, like a child.
Yes, somebody had to take the spoon all the way to her mouth.
Yes, please.
Yes, but she started feeding herself.
She started feeding herself at day six, after day
yes.
six. Yes.
Yes, please.
Hey, this is shocking.
Therefore, on 14, that is around 13 weeks, she
yes.
was now able to wake herself from the bed to a sitting position.
She was now able to sit up on her own.
Yes, from a lying to a sitting position on herself, alone.
Yes, please.
Yes. That was a big miracle that we rejoiced because you didn't now need anybody to hold her to sit down.
Yes, please.
We just found her seated on her bed.
You would just find her seated on her bed, on her own.
Yes, and this time now you could speak together for long without her getting tired.
Yes.
Yes, that's on the near 2 weeks down the line.
Yes, please.
Yes, please.
Amazing, very amazing indeed.
Then on 6th of July.
6th of July.
Another thing happened. All this time she was not able to turn her neck to sides.
Yes.
Then she turned her neck from side.
Yes.
Which was stiff all this time.
Yes.
Yes, that was another big milestone.
Big milestone. She began turning her neck. So all along her neck was stiff and could not turn.
Yes, could not turn.
So after the rigor mortis that she went through, her neck had not yet recovered to normal up to 6th of
yes,
June.
Up, July, yes, up 6th to July. On the line also.
Yes, please.
Yes, her neck now would turn from side to side.
Yes.
Yes.
Wow. Yes, please.
Then, on 7th, that was on a Friday.
Yes.
Big miracle inside a miracle.
A big miracle inside this mighty miracle and sign and wonder.
We told her to stand. We were holding her to stand.
Yes.
Then suddenly she started walking.
Oh, in the checkup when you were helping her, you held her to stand, and then All of a sudden you found her she is walking.
Yes, it was like a dream.
It was like a dream for you.
Yes, because I was not near her, but I was within the house.
Yes.
So I had a lot of shouts.
You had a lot of shouts.
Coming from her direction.
Yes.
And sometimes when you hear shouts, you don't know what those shouts are meaning.
Yes.
Are they for joy or are for bad news?
So you ran?
I ran very fast.
Yes, please.
Towards that direction.
Yes.
Usually you don't know what you expect. You don't know what you expect. He fell from the bed or what happened?
Yes.
I didn't expect her that she was, the noise was joyful noise.
Oh, yes, please.
Now, mommy and the daughter, even everybody was very happy.
Yes, please.
So I found that she was, but I was so surprised that she was walking.
You were shocked also when you found her walking.
And I joined in the celebration of shouting and the Lord, and hey, it was a big thing.
It was a big, big thing.
Hey, it was the joy of the day.
For the first time, she walked on 7th of July, 2017.
A dead corpse walking.
A dead corpse walking, Daktari.
Hey, it was joyful.
Yes, please.
See, my doctor could participating also and being part of the rejoicing.
Yes.
Yes, Bishop Charan.
It's amazing. The Lord allowed you to see that moment, as in he knows, of course, that you have been documenting all this and shocked and stunned at the reversal of death, and they allowed you to see that moment when she stood up and began walking.
Yes, and I thank the Lord that our phones can take videos. That's when we took that video.
Yes.
That
you took the video, you documented on video for the first time on that day. When she stood
up. That's a real live video that was going on that day.
Yes.
Yes, we were celebrating.
Hallelujah.
Then on Saturday, she was walking.
Saturday, she was walking.
Yes, was getting strength.
Yes.
Then on 12th of July.
Yes, please.
That's around.
Yes.
22 days down the line.
Yes, please.
Now she could shout. Her voice came out strongly.
Her voice was, now she regained her voice and was strong.
She could call somebody while in her bedroom.
Yes.
And somebody in the sitting room would hear.
Yes.
Yes.
Her voice came back now stronger. Why? What's the science behind that?
Yes, brothers. Now her lungs now can produce enough.
Yes.
Air.
Yes.
To come through her voice box.
Yes, please.
And reach far.
Mm-hmm.
And also the muscles in her body.
Even the muscles in her body, yes.
The chest were strong enough to squeeze the chest to produce that voice.
Yes, please.
Because when for voice to come out, you need all the muscles of the diaphragm.
Yes.
The chest wall.
Yes.
Yes, for you to produce such a voice.
Yes.
So she's gaining strength.
Yes.
Yes, then the other thing, apart from the appetite.
Yes, please.
There are some things that she started selecting.
Hey.
Like on TV, but on 10th of July.
Yes.
Suddenly she wanted lamb chops.
Oh, yes, please.
And we put 4 kilograms of lamb chops.
Yes, please.
She really ate them.
Yes, please.
So she was selective on what she wanted to eat.
Now she was selective on what she wants to eat.
Then the following day she wanted honey.
Yes.
The goodness of honey was around and she ate a lot of honey.
She just wanted to eat honey.
Honey continuously. In fact, up to now, she's still eating honey.
Yes.
Yes, apart from the other food, she really wants honey.
Yes.
So the body now is selecting what? And bananas.
And bananas.
That's good. All, as I told you, the body loved all the minerals.
Yes.
That's why I think the both you have to eat, depending on which minerals you need most at a particular time.
Yes, please.
Yes, so bananas give her potassium.
Yes, please.
That we always in her room where she's sleeping.
Yes, please.
This food, then one of the food that doesn't lack there is bananas.
Must be there. Bananas.
Must be there.
Yes.
Yes, apart from drinks.
Yes, please.
And milk too.
Yes, please.
Yeah, she needs a lot of protein. She needs a lot of. She needs everything.
Yes.
Yes.
Amazing. Yes.
So on 22nd day, her voice was very loud.
Her voice was very loud.
And worshiping.
Yes.
Now you could hear the worship from her house.
Oh, she also loves to worship.
Yes.
So you could hear her worshipping from afar.
Yes, from afar.
Yes.
Yes.
Mm.
Then the other thing also, on this Wednesday.
Yes.
Most of the time she has been sleeping during the day.
Yes, please.
In other words, she sits for short and sleeps.
Yes.
But from Wednesday, this week.
Yes.
She has been sitting most of the time in the sitting room.
Yes.
Watching the videos of the mighty prophet of the Lord's meeting.
Yes, please.
Yes, one of them is watching Baby Charlene, Paula.
Yes.
And she has been glorifying the Lord when she saw those all miracles.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, so she, for the last 3 days.
Yes, please.
During the day, we have been sitting together.
Yes, please.
Talking together.
Yes, please.
In other words, now she can talk for a long time without getting tired. She's regaining back her strength.
She's regaining back her strength.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
She can walk, but yesterday.
Yes, please.
For the first time, she walked outside the house of the compound.
She walked outside to the compound, the house to the compound, yes.
But she cannot walk for long because she easily gets tired. The blood is still low.
Yes.
So she gets very tired easily, but she can walk. But what is holding her not to walk for long, she gets very tired.
Yes, please.
And the heart beats very faster.
The reversal of the process of death. Hey.
Yes, please.
It is a myriad of things.
Myriad of things.
Yes, please.
But the rate of recovery is astonishing.
Yes.
Very fast.
Hey, very shocking.
Yes, no medical intervention, no IV fluids, nothing. These are natural reversal of death.
No medical intervention, no drugs, nothing. Only the Lord himself.
The Lord himself has taken control of her health.
Yes.
Yes, all these things are happening mysteriously as we see.
Yes.
Yes, it's miracles, signs of, and wonder of the age.
To you as a doctor, you say it's just happening, it's mysterious, it's an enigma.
What? Very true. What has made me to be comfortable is because I know it's the Lord who is in control.
Yes, please.
Or else I would be very worried to be with her and not do anything.
Yes, please.
Yes. So Mama Rosa's recovery has been very astonishing, very fast.
Yes.
Very rapid.
Very rapid, very shocking.
Very shocking.
Yes, please.
But now, yesterday.
Yesterday.
On 8th,
yes, please.
As I told you, that short-term memory came back.
Yes.
That short-term memory came back on 26th of June.
Yes.
She could remember people.
Yes.
But she didn't have the long-term memory.
She didn't have the long-term memory.
Long-term memory means remembering of what you did like as ago, 10 years ago.
Yes.
So now on 8th of, it's a Saturday.
Yes.
The long-term memory came back. She started now remembering how she gave birth. Our children were before.
Eh.
Remembering where she was sometimes 10 years ago.
Eh. Yes.
Yes.
Amazing. Yes.
In other words, the brain function has been restored fully now.
The brain functions have been restored fully now.
Yes. The intestines have been restored fully now. She can eat like any other person.
Yes, please.
Now she doesn't have now to eat frequently, small and frequent. Now she can eat like, she can take 4 hours, eat a good size of food.
Yes.
And rest it.
Yes, please.
Because in other words, things are normalizing.
Things are now normalizing without medical intervention. Very shocking.
Yes.
Yes.
So up to today, Mama Rosa, yesterday, worked for the first time outside the compound.
Yes.
So precious listeners, what is holding her not to work for that long is that she still has some pain in her joint.
Yes.
The right knee joint.
Yes.
In other words, the joints were very stiff initially because of the rigor mortis.
when she underwent rigor mortis, the joints died and was stuck and became stiff.
Yeah, in fact, they are doing some massages, massaging her muscles.
Yes.
That's the only thing they are doing, and she's feeding very well.
Yes.
She's sleeping during the night very well, and she's not eating much during the night like before.
How does it feel as a doctor that all this time, it's now day 22, if I counted well, to see and document the reversal of the processes of death without any medical intervention?
Yes, precious listeners and Senior Bishop Joanne.
Yes, please.
As a doctor, I'm now knowing my who is God, really.
You say you are rediscovering God Almighty.
I thought I was a doctor.
Yes.
But now I'm understanding that what I know is so little as compared to what I didn't know.
Yes, please.
Yes, there are some things that I thought I usually intervene.
Yes.
Most probably thing is me who did it.
Yes.
Now I'm realizing that it's a greater physician.
Uh-huh.
Yes, and the way Mama Rosa is recovering is my joy.
Yes.
Because a doctor, usually your joy is to see your patient recovering very well.
Yes, please.
And that's why we usually give them drugs and see if I can intervene surgical or whichever way you can intervene for somebody to be well.
Yes.
And then I'm sitting with somebody who recovered from death.
Yes.
Lost all her functions.
Yes.
And I'm seeing all the organs very well.
Yes.
And those ones that are not functioning are recovering very fast.
Yes.
It's my joy.
Very shocking, very mighty.
But is there somebody who is joyful is a doctor?
Yes, please.
Seeing her patients recovering very well.
Yes.
Though I'm sitting with somebody that I'm not interfering in any head anyway.
Yes.
Only in shock, seeing how fast he's recovering.
Just watching how the Lord is doing it and documenting it.
And see what the Lord himself is doing.
Yes.
So I'm documenting the dreams of the Lord.
You're documenting the doings of the Lord in the life of Mama Rosa, who was resurrected.
Yes, please, who was dead and resurrected.
Who died and was resurrected by the mightiest prophet of the Lord. Very shocking, very mighty things, Daktari.
Yes, there's a prophet in the land, Senior Bishop Joanne.
You say there is the mightiest prophet of the Lord is in the land.
It's true, but most probably you have not understood him very well.
Oh, you're saying most probably we have not understood him very well.
We didn't know who is in the midst of us.
Yes.
Yeah, we thought he's just like any other prophet.
Yes.
But we are now realizing that he's more than a prophet.
He is more than a prophet.
Yes, please.
Yes.
And therefore what he is saying, we need to take it very seriously.
We need to take it very seriously.
Because those words traveled all the way at midnight from Nairobi to South Pokot.
Yes.
And the person whom the words were going to was dead.
Yes.
But the words resurrected that person.
Aye, very, very fearful.
So that tells you how mighty, mightiest that person is.
Yes, please.
Yes, that he's able to send a word.
Yes.
Not even call them, but only write a message.
Just send a text, just send a message.
Yes, the message went through steps. Two to three people.
Yes.
But very powerful words.
But did not lose its power.
It did not lose its power, Senior Bishop John, very true.
Yes.
The power was still the same.
The power was still the very same.
The resurrecting power.
Yes.
That has done this.
Yes.
And the region of Jeparta where Mama Rosa comes in.
Yes, please.
Has been a beehive of activities.
Ever since then, it has become a beehive of activities.
Because when you realize that the village has...
Yes.
...are still flowing with that village.
Yes.
That tells how serious it was and how true it was.
That is how serious and how true it was.
And that's why Mama Rosa, all these milestones are coming up just to show us...
Yes.
...those who are still doubting.
Yes.
I'm sure people can do it even in one day. I don't know. I cannot think for the Lord.
Yes, please.
But the reason why Mama Rosa is undergoing all these stages...
Yes, please.
It's for them that are doubting to come to believe that truly there's a mighty prophet in the land.
Oh, yes.
Who resurrected Mama Rosa.
Yes.
Then what I do would not be true in another day.
Yes.
If the Lord resurrects another person.
Yes.
If the mightiest prophet of the Lord that he has seen.
Yes.
Resurrects another person.
Yes.
Most probably the things would not be the same again.
Yes.
Because how the Lord does these things is not, cannot be predicted.
You say the systems cannot be predicted.
You cannot predict what the Lord does.
Yes.
And you cannot kill for the Lord.
Yes.
So, precious listeners, as a doctor,
yes,
this is what has happened in the body of Mama Rosa, to tell you that she died and she is now recovering.
So we should just surrender to the Lord.
Yes, and how she's recovering is so amazing.
Yes, please.
But no medical intervention, but she's recovering in a very miraculous, in a sign, in still that wonder.
Yes, please.
To me as a doctor.
Yes.
Yes, please.
Thank you so much, Doctor. Is there anything else that you wanted us to know?
Yes, please, precious listeners.
Yes, please.
If that comes up, I will let my listeners know, the people who have been following these signs and wonder.
Yes, please.
I will let you know, Senior Bishop Joanne.
Thank you so much. We are so blessed that you found time. We know you're very, very busy as a consultant, senior consultant surgeon, and as a professor of medicine and surgery, and also, of course, because of your work in the hospital. But thank you for finding time to talk to us and help us understand the processes of the reversal of death.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Glorify the Lord.
Yes, please.
And thank the mightiest prophet of the Lord.
Yes, please.
For here, for being with us.
Yes, please.
And for working tirelessly, even at midnight, still praying for us.
Oh, yes, please.
Yes, he should have been awake by all standards at that time.
Yes, it was way past midnight.
But he could not sleep.
Yes.
Because he listens and does the will of the Lord whom sent him.
Yes, please.
Yes, so thank you so much, mightiest prophet of the Lord.
We thank the mightiest prophet of the Lord very much.
And thank you, Jesus, amen, for loving us this much and raising Mama Rosa.
Hallelujah. And we thank Jesus very much for raising Mama Rosa.
Amen, amen.
Thank you, Doctor. Thank you indeed. Thank you so much.